Hello there, this is Paula from Replicon. Replicon offers a lot of reports. Reports that cover just about any kind of data you can capture, from timesheet, time off booking, and expense sheet data, to payroll, project, and resourcing data. In this video, I'm going to give you an overview of how to use Replicon's reports. I'll cover the following: creating a report, configuring a report, running a report, and saving, sharing, and publishing a report. And finally, I'll try to help you answer the question, what report should I use? You have two choices when you use Replicon reports. You can run one of the default reports listed on the reports page by clicking the report name, or you can create a report based on a report template. Click the New Report button to do this and select the name of a template. So which of these options should you choose? Default reports are based on report templates. You can see which template a default report is based on by clicking the Settings button and looking in the top right-hand corner of the dialog that displays. A report and a template it's based on offer the same fields, but differ in which ones are enabled, that is, which ones will appear in the generated report. You can enable and disable fields in default reports or templates, so both can get you to the same place. That said, many people will start with the default reports, since they're set up to solve particular problems. Plus, the reports page offers descriptions of the default reports, which can help you decide which report to use. But note, if you're going to edit a default report, remember to save it as a copy with a new name, so you can retain the default version. Also note that most communication we provide about reports, like our reports field matrix that lists all report fields against the reports they're found in, references only report templates, not default reports. Whether you've based a report on a template or used a default report, you can configure the report settings so it matches your requirements. If you're using a default report, click the Settings button to open the Settings dialog. If you're adding a report based on a template, this dialog will open automatically after you select your template. In the Settings dialog that displays, on the left, you'll see a list of report columns, also referred to as report fields. These fields are enabled and will appear in the generated report. On the right is a list of all columns available to include in the report. You can use this field to search for particular columns. You can enable columns by clicking the checkboxes. The columns will show up in the list on the left side. You can remove a column from the report by either unchecking a box or by clicking the X here. If data you need isn't available in a report field, you may be able to generate it using report custom columns. Custom columns are report fields that are based on a formula you create using existing report columns. So for example, if you wanted to have your total labor cost plus expenses for a project calculated automatically and included in a report, you could create a custom column with the formula actual cost plus actual expense in a report based on the project template. You can also configure grouping and summary options for a report. For example, you could choose the sum option to display the sum total for a column. Summary options are only available for certain columns. That is, you won't see a sum option for a text-based column, since you can't sum text. Other summary options are also available, such as average, maximum, or minimum. And you can also choose how data is grouped in the report, by choosing which rows or columns to group by from these fields. For example, if you choose to group row data by project in a report, the report will look like this. When you're done configuring your settings, click Done. There's one final way of configuring reports, changing how data is filtered. Filtering can make it easier to focus on the data you're interested in. To change which filters are available, click the Edit link in the Filters section and enable or disable filters. Then you can choose what data you want to display from each filter. For example, if you only want to view data for one user, you can choose that user's name from the user filter. As you can see, many filters are in fact groupings of several sub-filters. So you can filter, for example, not just for a particular user, but by properties assigned to that user, like their department or supervisor name. So it's possible to be very selective about what data displays in the report. Once you've configured your report and selected your filter data, click the Run Report button to generate the report based on those settings. Then, if you find you want to refine your settings or filters, you can go back and reconfigure things. But remember that whenever you make changes to your report settings, you must be sure to click the Run Report button again to see your updated data. Once you've generated a report, there are a few things you might want to do with it. First, you probably want to save it. If you don't, any changes you've painstakingly made to the default report or template won't be retained. To save a report, click Save. If you're working from a default report, the Save button will only be available if you've made changes to the report, and your changes will be saved under the default report's name. If you don't want to overwrite the default, click Save a Copy and save the edited version with a new name. If you're working from a report template, you'll also need to give the report a name. In either case, the new report with all of your configured settings saved will display in the report list on the reports page. In addition to saving the report, there's a good chance you'll want to share a report with your colleagues. Click the share icon to share with other Replicon users in your organization. The report will show up on their reports list page. If you want to send the report to one or more individuals on a regular basis, click Set Schedule to set up a recurring schedule, like once a week on Fridays. The report will be generated and sent at the selected time. Or you can email the report one time only by clicking this envelope icon. Finally, you can export the report's data to Excel or PDF, or print the report by clicking these icons. As I mentioned, Replicon offers a lot of reports. In the timesheet reports section alone, we offer up to 9 default reports, each one aimed at answering a particular question or solving a particular business problem. So how do you decide which report to use? First, compare the names and descriptions in the Replicon interface. That may give you all the information you need. Or you could use our product documentation. We offer a large number of help topics related to reports, including our report field definitions topic, which defines key report columns, and our choosing a report topic, which links to more information about reports and their uses. And many customers find our reports field matrix, available in XLS and PDF format, useful in comparing reports. It lists each report column we offer by the report template or templates it appears in. For more information about reports, or to find the documents I mentioned a moment ago, visit www.replicon.com/help. Click a role, Administrators, for example, and click Reports in the side menu. If you need more help, visit our community or contact our support team. That's all for me for now. Thanks for your time.